learners to the Education Online program. I'm teacher Regina Massimo, teaching you biology for senior 3 and senior 4. Our topic is structures of respiratory system in the birds. So you want to see the respiratory system in the birds. How is it built up? So the respiratory system in the birds is built up of mouth, nostril, pharynx, trachea, 9 air sacs, and lungs. The respiratory system in birds is made up of 1 mouth, 2 nostrils, which is called nares, 3 pharynx, 4 trachea, 5 9 air sacs. 9 air sacs. Lastly, lungs. The lungs. So we can see from here, this is a sketch of a bird. The respiratory system is made up of the mouth, then the nostril here, followed by pharynx, then the trachea, then the 9 air sacs are as follows. 1 interclavicular sac, it is only 1, but the rest of the air sacs, you find them 2-2. So we have 2 cervical sac, we can see from the drawing here. We have 2 anterior thoraxis sac, that means we have it this side and we have it the other side too. We have 2 posterior thoracic sac, here 1 and the other side here also. Then 2 abdominal sac. So the total of air sac are 9. Yeah, these are the 9 air sacs, interclavicular air sac is only 1. Then cervical air sac, there are 2 on either sides. Posterior, anterior thorax, or thoracic air sac, also 2. Then posterior thoracic air sac is also 2. Then the last one is abdominal abdominal air sac. Abdominal air sac. There are also two. So it makes total of 9. 2, 2, 2, 8 plus 1 interclavicular air sac. It makes the total of 9 air sac. So this is how the structure or the respiratory system is made up in birds or built up in birds. Then let's come to see the function of these parts of the respiratory system or the structures of the respiratory system. This mouth is used for what? The birds draw in air through mouth or nostril. Mouth or nostril, they are used to draw air into the body. Then the air passes through the pharynx. So the pharynx is a just a passage of the air or air pass. Air pass. Then reaching to the trachea. Here the trachea is divided into two. The trachea in the bird is as long as the neck is here. The pharynx is here. So the trachea is as long as the neck of the bird. So here the trachea is divided into two. Primary bronchi. That means it is divided into two. It's called primary bronchi. Bronchi. So we can observe this from the other side of the drawing. This one. We have the thorax here. The mouth and the nostril, then the pharynx reaching to the trachea in the region known as syrinx. This syrinx here serve as voice box in the birds. Voice box. So when the trachea reaches this region here, it gets divided into two. So each branch is called primary bronchi. Then the bronchi enter into the lungs. The bronchi enters into the lungs. When it enters into the lungs, the air continues to flow. The air continues to flow through the pharynx and the trachea. So from the trachea, which is divided into two, now the air will proceed to the posterior air sac. Let me grab this one. Because these 9 air sacs can be divided into functional, can be divided into anterior air sacs and posterior functionally, the 9 air sacs can be divided into 2 groups, anterior air sac and posterior air sacs. When we say anterior air sac, we mean the interclavicular air sac plus cervical air sac and anterior thoracic air sac. Up to here, this one is classified under or grouped under anterior. Then from the posterior thoracic sac up to abdominal air sac, which is this one, this is the posterior thoracic air sac on both sides, then the abdomen, abdominal air sac, these are classified under posterior air sac. So the air flow from the pharynx to the trachea, which is divided into 2 primary bronchi, then the primary bronchi enters into the lungs, and this lung is well equipped with air capillaries. Air capillaries within the lungs here. And these air capillaries are surrounded by blood capillaries. Blood capillaries. So the air comes immediately to the posterior air sacs. That means we'll fill the abdominal air sac and the posterior thoracic air sac. Then from there, it moves into the lungs. Again, from lungs, the air moves into the anterior air sacs. That means from the lungs here, we'll start coming back to the anterior thoracic air sac and interclavicular air sac. From there to the trachea for it to come out. So this is just an explanation about how the 9 air sacs work. So we want to see how do birds breathe. The birds blow air through mouth or nostril. Birds draw air through mouth or nostrils. When this air is drawn in, the air passes through the air passes through the pharynx, then into the trachea. The trachea is as long as the neck of the bird. And it is divided into two primary brunji. The primary brunji enter the lungs where air capillaries are, and these air capillaries are surrounded by blood capillaries. Because the gas exchange, it takes place within the air capillaries between the lungs and the blood. So the air continue to flow. These air capillaries are surrounded by a network of blood capillaries, by network of blood capillaries. Then the air continue to flow through the trachea and bronchi into the posterior air sacs. Then the air continues. The air continues to flow. Or the air flows through trachea and primary bronchi into the posterior air sacs, posterior air sacs. That means the air comes from here. Let us consider this one. Comes from here, rushing to the this abdominal air sac and the posterior air sac. Then again, the same air moves to the anterior air sac. Again, the air moves from the lungs to the anterior air sacs. Anterior air sacs, we mean the interclavicular air sac and plus anterior thoracic air sac, for it to reach the trachea. So then the air move from the posterior air sac into the lungs, and again from there moves into the anterior air sacs and trachea to leave the body. Into the lungs. And trachea. And trachea. To leave the body or to come out of the body. To come out of the body. because reaching the trachea here will come out either through the mouth or through the nostril. So, as the air passes through the lungs, coming through the primary bronchi to the posterior air sac, moving from the lungs, moving from the posterior air sacs to the lungs, from the lungs to the anterior air sac, in this process, the oxygen molecule is diffusing, passes through the lungs, oxygen molecules in the air is exchanged for the carbon dioxide. So, as we said, the two lungs are well equipped with air capillaries, and that air capillaries are surrounded by network of blood capillaries. So, as the air passes from the lungs, the oxygen molecule is exchanged for the carbon dioxide. That means the oxygen diffuses from the air capillaries. Oxygen, that means the oxygen diffuses from the air capillaries. Into the blood. Because the air capillaries are surrounded by network of blood capillaries. And the carbon dioxide diffuses into the air capillaries from the blood, diffuses from the blood into the air capillaries for it to be sent out of the body. So this means the gas exchange in the birds take place within the air capillaries between the lungs and the blood. Here we can conclude it as like this. The gas exchange in the birds take place within air capillaries, the gas exchange in the birds take place within air capillaries between the lungs and blood. And from the process of the airflow, we landed, the birds have two respiratory cycles. Birds have two respiratory cycle. Because in the first, the air come straight to the posterior air sacs, then move to the lungs. Then another inhalation take place, the air from the lungs move into the anterior air sacs. From there to be sent out of the body, should reach the trachea, then to the mouth or the nostril. So thanks, up to here. We are done with our topic of today.